University of Southern California. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the golden broadcast of USC's only news radio talk show. My name is Conrad Wilton, and this is, of course, Conrad's Corner. I want to appreciate everybody joining us for Facebook, Twitter, all that great stuff. We even had in the Daily Trojan, we spent some money during the LA Times Book Four and Book Fair, and rather actually advertised the Rules of Romance panel, Scintillating Stories and Secrets to Success. That's what's going to lead us off. We have Claire Pyres and Heather Ritchie on the radio show in a pre-recorded panel. It's a good thing it was pre-recorded, because it was very interesting, to say the least. And just listening to it last night, you guys are going to enjoy it. It's two very different people with two rather different perspectives, and going to be giving up their life experiences and uncovering the secrets to romantic success. We're going to get to that in just a second. Don't forget, you're listening to KXSC 1560 AM Los Angeles, and also online at KXSC.org. All the Conrad's Corner interviews and segments can be found online. Just go to Conrad's Corner, USC.com. Let's lead it off with the Rules of Romance with Claire Pyres and Heather Ritchie. You're listening to Conrad's Corner, USC's only news radio talk show. Mm-hmm. All right, ladies and gentlemen, my name's Conrad Wilton, inside the Annenberg Radio News Studio once again, alongside two very, very interesting people. We'll just put it at that. It's the incomparable Claire Pyres joining us for the Rules of Romance, Scintillating Stories, Secrets to Success. Claire, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Very well, very good. Well. And from Alpha Phi, representing Greek Row, we have Heather Ritchie on the show. Heather.
Hi.
Well, I mean, I figured you can't have a show about romance without talking about Greek Row, considering a lot of it happens over there.
Yes.
So here's the first question, guys. And it's not like a game show or anything like that, so always feel free to chime in. You know, you don't have to take turns here. But when I say the words romance, or just the word romance, what comes to mind? Do you think of something long-term? You think of something short-term? What is it that comes to your mind, Claire?
I think of someone who doesn't spend all their time thinking about themselves. They open up a little part of themselves to think about the other person that they really like.
Oh, that's too
and
beautiful.
I think of little kisses and little gifts and little talks.
Okay.
I'm going to start crying.
No, that's okay. That's okay. We just started,
Conrad.
Hold on.
How about you, Heather? Nice to meet
you.
I think long-term, obviously, but on Greek Row, it's usually short-term, unfortunately.
You would verify that.
Yes.
It's a haven for short-term relationships.
I would say 95% are short-term.
Right.
Wow. I mean, there are the 5% that actually do make it. I know a couple that actually met on spring break in Cabo drunkenly, and they still have been dating for a year. So
Pretty good.
It can happen, but it is very rare.
So rule number one, there is always exceptions to the rules.
Yes.
It's always possible.
There's exceptions.
And I know that you rushed a sorority, Claire, and you, Greek Row wasn't exactly, it couldn't tame you.
No, it didn't tame me, Conrad. Let's get real on Annenberg Radio on Conrad's Corner.
That's what it's all about.
It did not tame me. I am a little crazy, Heather. I just met you literally 5 minutes ago.
And she's about to tell your entire life story right here.
No, I would need a little mystery. I mean, we are in Los Angeles. But I feel like, you know, Greek life was very restricted to me. It was very traditional. It was very much like a guy takes a girl to a dance, and on Mondays you get gifts from guys, and I just wanted more crazy stories and a more, you know, filled life. And I feel like a lot of people can get that from Greek life, but I wasn't really raised traditionally, and so I was sort of suffocated.
Right. Well,
I can see that.
One of the things you can verify this, because I'm currently not on Greek Row, so this is all in theory. That's another rule. Everything I say is actually in theory, not necessarily in practice, except for a couple things. But Greek Row seems like a place where people are surrounded by the opposite sex all the time. All the time. So wouldn't it be difficult, in your opinion, to actually date someone who is on Greek Row when you're not on Greek Row? So you're not really in the scene.
Like if the person you're dating is on Greek Row, but you're not?
Correct.
Okay.
Are most relationships Greek?
Most, yes. Yeah. Just because you're always doing mixers and formals and date dashes and things like that. So yeah, you're usually surrounded by Greek men, which can be a good or bad thing depending on how you look at it. But it is refreshing meeting men that aren't in the Greek system.
Right, right. Of course. And Claire, you have any thoughts on that? Have you tried dating a guy who's in a fraternity?
No, the last guy I sort of pseudo-dated when it was really just physical, for getting real in Conrad's Corner, was a football player who was humongous. Which we talked talked about live.
That's
on
right.
Air.
So we might as well do it here on Conrad's Corner. You guys got it on in the hybrid. And So rule number, I guess another rule of romance is that no matter how small the car is, it's always possible.
Unless you're a football player. And then it's very crammed. And right. With that, next question.
Okay. So would you say, though, that most students here at USC are ultimately looking for a long-term partner? Or no? Do you think that it's more of the experimental aspects here in college? Because a lot of teen people think it's hookup culture, short term here at USC. Or is that true?
I think it's yes and no. I think freshman and sophomore year, I know I was guilty of it. I went into the dorm and was like, oh, there's so many men. Like, I just want to meet them and kiss them and just do everything. But, like, Heather. You know, getting into junior and senior years, you're just kind of like, you're getting more serious about studies. You're thinking about work and internships. And you're like, wow, I actually have to, like, kind of settle down in life right now. So yeah. I would say it's kind of a little bit of mixed.
What are the secrets to finding a long-term partner? Have you guys been successful in that regard? Has there been a long-term relationship here in the room? And it's not coming from my end, I'll tell you that.
Conrad, you're so nice and very cute.
Well, thanks. Thank you, Claire. But last I heard you were, well, anyway.
Okay. On air.
Not on the air. But what would you say is, how successful have you been in that regard?
Long-term, not successful here. Just because there's a lot of temptation on both ends.
Right,
like, there really is. Like, I'm guilty of it too, going to a party of some sort, and there's just five good looking men in the room. And right. I'm sure he's guilty of it too, seeing there's gorgeous women at our school. Let's be real here. Like, we have one of the best looking schools in the country.
That's why it's so hard to be attached to somebody. How do you go to these parties knowing that it's not available? It's window shopping. You know what I mean?
And the sad part is with me is that my two majors are very girl heavy majors. So I don't meet very many men besides men on the Greek row. So right. I'm very constricted to men on the Greek row, unfortunately.
Yeah. One of the secrets here to Annenberg is that it is, I mean, I did not know this coming in, but it's just surrounded by women.
Very, very female heavy.
Yeah. So, definitely. And also in our majors, too, all
theater
the guys
major.
Are gay.
Theater, yeah.
Mostly.
Well, yeah.
There's the 99%. 99%. I would leave 1%. I have
for the
met
questioning.
Some.
Yeah, so you're more likely to find a good guy friend who is interested in your other guy friend than you are to find a good relationship.
Exactly.
Here's a question. If so, let's say you really like someone who's taken. Okay, I'm sure maybe this has happened once in a while. What's the policy for how aggressive should you go for it? Should you be around? Should you really go at it? Should you what's your call?
Personally,
on that?
For me, this is my own thing. If I know that he has a girlfriend, I just consider that off limits because if I were that girlfriend, I would be very offended and be very hurt if a girl purposefully went out and tried to pursue him when she knew. If I didn't know that he had a girlfriend, I thought he was single, I'd totally go for it.
Right.
Yeah,
but
too.
If I found out he had a girlfriend, I'd be like, you know, I'm going to respect her territory. I'm not going to do it. That's just me.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. If I know that he has a girlfriend, then I'm not going to pursue that because right. I am crazy, but I'm not selfish. But if he doesn't have a girlfriend, then hell yeah.
Well, of course. But this is like what goes around comes around, so it's
exactly.
about respecting.
Definitely. Well, and you don't want to get a bad name as being a homewrecker.
And women unite together, you know? We don't want to screw that other girl over.
No.
Okay, so another topic. How about taking technological shortcuts? Has a guy ever asked you out via text, Facebook, email, all that stuff? What's your take on that?
Well,
yay,
the new
terrible.
Thing... It's awful. And the new thing is, okay, can we go back to the footballer?
Please,
he's probably
going
to see every type of, you know, social media that you and I have talked about this on, but, or, you know, TV, radio. But, okay, so we are in my car, you know, or wherever we are, right? Then he waits like 3 weeks to text me, and the text is like, where are you? I'm sorry.
Is it at 2 a.m.? Because that's usually the text. Where are you at 2 a.m.?
Like, I'm drinking gin by myself, honey. Like, leave me alone. You know? Mm-hmm. I mean, and I'm thinking, are you serious? Like, are you serious right now? That is a booty call.
Oh, it is. Well, I think anything after midnight, I consider a booty call.
Wouldn't that be a booty text?
And it's like, I'm not your football ball you toss around.
Right.
This is not the season, honey.
What I think is interesting is if you're willing to, I mean, go all the way with somebody, wouldn't you have the guts to at least call them up beforehand?
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It just seems, I mean, a text seems just too easy.
That's because I feel like guys don't have as much balls anymore.